comparison with the digital mechanics program, low cost set memory polygons. Computational fluid mechanics is a scientific area with great needs for computer power. Parallelization is a way to obtain results in much less computational time. There are two main computational systems today, self-memory system and distributed memory system. In self-memory system, all processors use data from the same memory, and the distributed memory system, each group of processors has its own memory. Distributed memory systems can be built cluster, which combine low cost and high efficiency, and they are widely used in scientific computing. To take advantage of such computer system, parallelization of the program is required. In this way, parallelize the program for self-memory architecture is used the OpenMP. OpenMP is embedded in many compilers, and there is no need for big changes in our code. To see how easy it is to parallelize a code using OpenMP, we can see this do loop. We can parallelize this by just adding three OpenMP directives commands. MPI is a way to parallelize our program for distributed tensor memory, but especially for distributed memory systems. And it's a little bit tougher rather than OpenMP because the programmer must arrange the communication between the processors in order to exchange data. In this work, we want to evaluate the efficiency of CFD problems solved with parallel algorithms on self-memory systems. We will focus on self-memory systems because they are low cost but powerful processors that we can find them in everyday routine, and because they are part of distributed memory systems. Two fields of computational mechanics is computational fluid mechanics and molecular dynamics. We will focus on computational fluid mechanics, and we will use the molecular dynamic problem just to make a small comparison. For the CFD, we will use the code ADREA-HF, and for the molecular dynamic code, the code GOMAX. ADREA-HF is in an in-house CFD code, which is developed for many years in our lab, and is specifically designed for atmospheric dispersion problems in complex geometries. It has multi-component and multi-phase capabilities. It has various turbulence models, both RAMs and LES, and various numerical sims. It also has a user-friendly graphical environment. ADREA-HF has widely been used in applications on hydrogen safety, and hydrogen dispersion in closed and open areas, and dispersion under cryogenic release conditions. ADREA-HF solves Navier-Stokes mass enthalpy and component mass fraction conservation equations, and for the discretization, it uses finite volume. We have recently parallelized ADREA-HF for both set and distributed memory architectures using OpenMP or MPI, and we try to find what improvements will further increase the efficiency of our parallelization. I will tell some things about how we parallelize the code. For the parallelization of ADREA-HF, we use the domain decomposition technique. The domain is splitting into some domains. Each subdomain is to have more or less the same number of cells, and the number of cells that resides on the boundary between the partitions will be as small as possible. Each processor is responsible for only one domain, and subdomain data are available only to one processor, and so if one domain is data from another, communication is required through MPI routines. An implicit CFD code usually consists of two main parts, discretization of the equation and the solution of linear system. The parallelization of the first part of the discretization of the equation is most straightforward through domain decomposition. And communication is mainly needed for the field data that has been calculated in the previous iteration in order to calculate the variables in the new iteration. The parallelization of the second part is not demanding because the linear system that occurs from the discretization is usually large and hard to solve, so we need fast iterative methods in order to solve them. Such methods are BC sub and DMRS, which are still representative of the general wheel of subspace method. In order to make this method more efficient, the technique that the install preconditioner must be embedded in the methods. preconditioning make algorithms converge in mass less iterations. Instead of solving the usual linear system, we use this system, where n is called the preconditioning matrix. The only change in the algorithm of this established GMRS, when we use preconditioning, is that in every iteration we need to solve one more linear system, the preconditional system, with matrix of unknown m. The choice of preconditioning is very crucial if you want to go faster. In general, M must be an easily reversed matrix so that the preconditional system not take too much time to resolve. Preconditioning methods that are widely used in CFD applications is ILU methods. In this method, the preconditioned matrix M is equal to the product of a lower and an upper triangular matrix. So it's very easily inverted. We parallelize this system by parallelizing its operations, the product between matrix and vector in the product, and operations of preconditional operations, and the construction of the preconditioner, and the solution of the preconditional system. ILU methods, although it is it's a very good preconditioner, it has strong serial character, and the parallelization is difficult. So for the parallel version of ADREA-HF, we use a slightly different preconditioner. Each process apply ILU preconditioning only for the data of its subdomain, and as a result, each process has its own preconditioning matrix, and all preconditioning operations can be carried out in parallel. Of course, by doing that, we lose some quality of the ILU of the serial preconditioner because we have lost the connection between between domains, and the number of iterations may increase. But we found that in our cases, this is not this is happening only for large, only if we use large number of many number of processors. For the validation of the efficiency of parallel iterative code, hydrogen dispersion in a single geometry is simulated. The scenario of the accident is a hydrogen leakage in a closed ventilated hallway. Hallway, which is a representation of a real industrial area. You can see in the figure the geometry of the problem. We have two openings for the natural ventilation of the room, one at the roof and one at the right wall. And the leakage rate of hydrogen is 3.4 cubic meters per hour, and its duration is 20 minutes. It is, the leakage is from here at the floor. Here we can see some results. The hydrogen concentration is about 4.5% per volume 20 minutes after the leakage has started. We can see that we have concentrations above 4% per volume, which is the lowest flammability level. So this accident might be dangerous. Molecular dynamic simulations are claimed which programmed with Gromax software, which is a free open source molecular dynamic program. It has large capability simulating complex system and special system of biological interest. A simple simulation problem was chosen for this program in order to evaluate the efficiency of the parallel code. We simulate the n-octane in order to calculate the density, heat capacity, and the radial distribution function. Three different set memory computer machines are used in order to evaluate the efficiency of parallel code. We can see in the table what processor we used and what are the characteristics. We must mention that any characteristics that make this processor have, which allow the operation system to alter the CPU frequency automatically based on the load, has been disabled, in order to make our comparison more reliable. We can see in these diagrams the speed up that we achieve with our code in as a function of number of CPUs. We have two grid sizes, one with 30,000 cells and one with 60,000 cells. One with the coarse mesh is the green line and the fine mesh is the orange line. We can see that in all cases, the green line is above the orange line. So as the number of cells increase, the speed up is decreasing. We also mentioned that as the number of CPUs increase, the speed up is decreasing, and you will see